Hi everyone, this is Venkatesh from Naresha Technologies. In this video, let us have a small discussion on stackless. Why I am concentrating on stackless? The stack class is a child class of vector. Sir, what is this vector? Vector is an implementation class of list. Sir, what is list? List is an interface which is extended from collection. So here, collection is an interface from java.util package, which is extended from java.lang.iterable interface. This collection interface further extended into list. So the list is an interface again. The list is implemented into three classes majorly: ArrayList, Vector and LinkedList. Among that, Vector is extended into one child class known as Stack. So majorly list is having three implementation classes. Among that, Vector is having a child class known as Stack class. That's a theory here. So let me speak on list first. So this collection interface further extended into three interfaces: set, list and queue. Set organizes elements without index value. List organizes elements with index value. Queue organizes based on first in, first out basis. Now we are concentrating on list. List can accommodate duplicate elements, can organize based on index value, having three implementation classes: ArrayList, Vector and LinkedList. This stack is a child class of Vector. ArrayList is a non-synchronized class. The meaning of non-synchronized class is the class which is not having any synchronized methods. We are calling it as non-synchronized class and non-thread safe class. And the Vector is a synchronized class having synchronized methods. This synchronized class means thread safe class. So synchronized method means what, sir? The method which is declared by using synchronized keyword, we are calling it as synchronized method. Advantage: in a multi-threading process, the synchronized methods are available to one thread at a time for execution. Because of this reason, synchronized classes, we are calling it as thread safe classes. So Vector is one thread safe class and synchronized class. Linked list organized based on their internal references. It is a non-sequential form and generates high performance. So Vector is extended into stack. Let me show in the library. So when we speak about javap java.util.collection, this collection is an interface which is extended from java.lang.iterable. A interface can be extended into interface. Now I want a list. So this list is internally extended from java.util.collection. Already collection is an interface. Collection is an interface. So interface extended to list. List is an interface. Now this list further implemented into I want vector. If you see this vector here, extends from abstract list, implements from list, clonable, serializable. Anyway, we are highlighting this implemented from list. So Vector class is an implementation class of list. This Vector is having some synchronized methods. Whenever a class is having a synchronized methods, the class comes under synchronized class. Comes under synchronized class and thread safe class. Moreover, it is a thread safe class. What is the advantage of synchronized methods? They are available to one thread at a time in multi-threading process. That's a theory. Now, we are concentrating on stack. So, I am concentrating on stack. The stack is extended from Vector. So, I will write one program based on this methods available from stack. Everybody knows stack. Stack organizes elements in first in, last out basis, or last in, first out basis. So these are the methods. Among that, one method is synchronized method. This one is synchronized. Synchronized already know. Pop method, push method, peak method, empty method, and search method. So push method means inserting the element into stack object. Pop method means removing the element from the stack object. Peak means displaying the top of the stack element. Empty, finding out the elements are available in the stack or not. Search, we are going to search for the object, nothing but element, returns integer value. But the search method searches the element in the stack from top of the stack to bottom of the stack and displays the position of the element where it is available. That's a theory. So now, based on these methods, let me show one small example program. This is available from java.util package. By syntax, stack sum integer. Now I want to add. Add is nothing but push operation, st dot. I am displaying from the stack. Whenever I am displaying from the stack, Andy, now I can display system dot out dot println st. This is stack 12, 14, 17, 10 and 19. Sir, I want to know the peak of the stack. If I run it, the peak is 19. So the last element is 19. If I perform pop, st dot pop, after pop operation, I am displaying it out. 12, 14, 17, 10, 19. The peak element is 19. Display stack again, because pop operation performed. After pop operation, I will put one message here. For understanding purpose, I will put one message. After pop operation, display stack is 10, because 19 has been removed. So what is the peak element now? 10. So I shown here push operation and pop operation. Sir, I want to add these elements. I want to add these elements. Sum is equal to 0. I must retrieve the element one by one. No, I must take the elements one by one. So I'll take the support of st dot. I'll take the support of for each. I'm taking for each. So whenever I want to retrieve the elements one by one, definitely one loop is needed. For each method, in last few videos I introduced. Here I'll write sum is equal to sum plus p. Simply I can say system dot out dot println sum is equal to sum. I am adding the element. I am adding these numbers now. 12 plus 14 26, 26 34, 44 and so on. Adding these numbers now, right? So the peak element 10 now, adding it out. So if we want to perform addition of individual elements from it, I took the support of for each. Here one lambda expression I am passing as parameter here. Moreover, whenever I am passing as parameter, it is a local variable, right? If I am trying to use this variable, that scope should be outside, because this is one method again, right? I am passing this as parameter. This is one method signature. So let us give the scope outside. Why I kept outside now? Main method, it is acting like expression. So whenever this main method is static, want to access static variable, I kept it as static. But here intention is stack class. So stack class is a synchronized class, which is a child class of java.util.vector. By using stack, we can perform first in, last out basis, and there are operations like push and pop. Whenever you want to perform search, into some k is equal to st dot search of any object name. I'll be looking for 12 now. Now system dot out dot println element found at position. I am calling it as k. Found at the position k now. So if I run it, if you observe here, Andy, 12, 14, 17, 10, 19, peak element 19, after pop operation 19 will go, this will come, peak is 10 now, adding of this is, what is the addition now, this is 26, 33, okay, 53 it is. I am looking for the element 12 now, that is at position 4. Sir, 12 is here, how the position 4? It has been searching from the top of the stack and 1, 2, 3, 4. The search operation on the stack performs from top of the stack to bottom of the stack. So, this is about search operation on your stack now. So, here pop method removes the element from peak of the stack and the push element will add it. So, these are the methods in our stack class and small introduction to stack class. Everybody knows array list vector, but they will be not knowing this stack class because I given a small demo on stack class, which is a child class to vector. It is not implemented directly from your list, it is a child class to vector. So, this is a small introductional video on your stack class. Thank you. Watch me on more videos in Naresha Technologies.